I'd like to welcome you to the Berks Community Action Program on BCTV. My name is Jodi Readinger. I'm BCAP's Community Relations Coordinator. We are live on Tuesday, August 2nd here at BCTV. We're always welcome for home viewers. I'm excited today because I have some guests in the studio with me. So I'm going to start with, today we're going to talk about Kids the Ball, which is a local initiative. For basketball players, it provides them the opportunity to participate in some tournaments, and it's all part of a bigger structure that I'm just learning about, so we're going to let one of my guests discuss that in a little bit more detail. I'd like to introduce today, to my left, I have Wesley Butler, who's one of the star athletes at Kids the Ball, just coming back from a big tournament. He's going to talk a little bit about what they do and the tournaments and how influential that has been for him and the kind of things they learn besides basketball, all kinds of life skills. To my right, I have Rick Perez, who is the head basketball coach at Reading High School, in addition to all kinds of other things, and a coach for Kids at Ball, and been involved with that and youth athletics in Berks County and Reading for a long time. And then all the way down the end is Mason Gonzalez, who is apparently a big supporter of Kids at Ball and a great cheerleader for the program. So we're going to talk a little bit about the program. So I know what Reading Kids the Ball does because it comes across my desk and they say we want money for stuff. but Mr. Perez, if you can tell us a little bit about what the program is and what it does, and then we'll...
Well, thank you, Jodi, first of all, for having us. This is a great opportunity and to really highlight, you know, how much bigger our program is. And how community-based our basketball program is at Reading. Mr. Butler, Mr. Winton Butler, who is an employee at the school and administrator at the school district, in addition to Tremaine Jones, have begun the KTB program. So once I had gotten a job as the head coach, it only made sense for us to then collaborate and work closely together. They have done an exceptional job of really aligning all of the potential student athletes who could possibly be Reading High basketball players. They have created a system that now provides traveling basketball opportunities for students 3rd through 10th grade. Wow. All Reading based, and it has been awesome. It has been awesome to watch. You have seen the pride really spread throughout our student athletes. But it's not just limited to basketball players, okay? I mean, from the parent involvement to their involvement in the community, to their academic focus, the program has truly been a home run and a model for success, at Reading High School.
Wow. So what you told me earlier was that any young person that's interested in basketball has an opportunity through Reading Youth Athletics to get involved with some kind of team and play basketball. So those that aren't coordinated like me mm-hmm. could still play. Mm-hmm. But the kids that have a little bit more talent and have the potential to someday be the next Lonnie Walker or Kari and the young men that have been so stellar this past year, they get funneled into the KTB and get that opportunity to do some traveling teams, some tournaments, and all that kind of stuff.
Yes, they do. The structure, Don today has also done an exceptional job putting together the Reading Youth Program, and who services hundreds of Reading youth every single year through football, through basketball, through track. They have a plethora of programs. So Tremaine really got his hands on the basketball side of things and helping Mr. Today. So as you had mentioned, both boys and girls have an opportunity from December to February to participate in our basketball league. I don't know the exact numbers, but I'll tell you one of the best sites I've seen and being part of the Reading High program is every Saturday morning at Milmont. And you see students, representing their schools, playing against each other. And it's just a wonderful scene. So I suggest anyone on any typical Saturday morning during that time, take the journey and watch and enjoy the day. It's a beautiful sight. Lots of community involvement from people refereeing, scorekeeping, concession stands. And so now what happens is then Tremaine or Mr. Butler will identify then students who student athletes who have the potential to then play at a higher level. And then that is where KTB then comes in. But it's, as I said, it has been great for us. Right now we have over 20 sixth through eighth graders who are over at Hoop Group, basketball camp at Albright, and it gives us an opportunity, you know, this morning, you know, myself, Coach Flowers, Coach Randall, get an opportunity to really get hands-on with these sixth through eighth graders, which is really an opportunity we wouldn't have had without the efforts of everyone involved with the KTB program.
Wow. I as we, you know, do more at BCAP with the youth and the youth mini grants, and I'm learning so much of the stuff that goes on, and it's been wonderful. You know, Reading has a reputation, and it's great to see these opportunities for kids. And I know one of my coworkers had said to me, in all seriousness a little while ago, that basketball is so popular because all you need is a ball and a net, rather than all the other equipment. And it's a really easy game to pick up, and it's great to see it so popular in the city and all kinds of pickup games. So Wesley, Mr. Perez says the kids start at third grade. Have you been involved with kids at ball since third grade?
Well, my fifth grade year, I started with Reading Youth.
Okay.
And ever since then, I've been playing on the KTV Blacktop team. And that's been a great experience because I never knew there was other competition out there besides playing on my school team. And KTV started, we go to a lot of places, and I like that we get out. Mm-hmm. Instead of playing in the playground, we actually go to colleges like Kutztown, Aubrey, Moravian College. You know, it's a great experience.
Oh, that's great. And one of the neat things we were able to do this year with BCAP was underwrite some of the tournament costs so that the students could get out to the colleges and they could see the college campuses and see that that's really something that they can focus on in the future. And Wesley, I'm sure his dad has been pushing college for him since he first started to walk and talk and go to school. But for some of the kids on the team, that hasn't been something their parents were exposed to. And that's a great opportunity for them to see that, yeah, a kid like me can get to college. So that's really neat. So you just came back from a tournament this weekend?
Yeah, Nationals.
Nationals. Yeah. Okay. And you said you didn't win it this time, huh?
No.
But if you follow the KTB Facebook page, they win a lot of stuff. They're always advertising, you know, showing their different trophies and things like that. But I think one of the great things I've noticed is, as Mr. Perez says, there's so much community involvement. That it's, you know, the parents are there. Your supporters and your cheerleaders, like Mason, are there. And they're cheering you on. The whole family gets involved. And it's something that kids can aspire to, that they're doing their first game with Reading Youth Athletics. So what was your favorite tournament this year, your favorite place that you went to?
Favorite tournament? I would have to say this tournament, Newark, New Jersey.
Okay.
The NJ Classic, that was probably favorite tournament.
And was that at a college or?
No, it was at a community center in Newark. But it was a big tournament on the East Coast that.
Oh, when I was in college, I worked for Macy's, and one of their flagship stores was in Newark, New Jersey, and the only thing I ever got to see of Newark was the train station and the little bus that took us from the train station to the building, because at that point, it wasn't a very safe city to walk in, so I'm glad your experience was a lot better. Okay, so Mr. Perez, you said a couple things that I want to reemphasize. The academic basis. You know, we hear so much about athletes and, you know, just scraping by with their grades and things like that. But this program really places an emphasis not only on the athletics, but on the academics and the community involvement, right?
Yes. Ms. Jodi, we take a lot of pride. We are working diligently on the whole person. You know, this is not just about basketball. That's just the incentive. That's just the character, you know, it's a game. That's the fun part of everything. But, you know, I really, none of this would be possible. And as Wesley, you know, can also discuss, there are so many people, and I know I've said it before and you've emphasized it again, there are so many people who are involved and truly stepping up to help. these student athletes. And what's happening is now they're having a better awareness of the importance of academics, you know, of being punctual, you know, the quality of their work. So, you know, there's on a daily basis, I'm getting a phone call, hey, I've helped tutor so-and-so, or I've taken so-and-so to help them with their math or whatever it may be. And just to know where we are as an entire community, it's very encouraging, and then makes people like myself work even harder, because, you know, I know their energy is driven by the hard work that Wesley's putting in. I mean, Wesley is an exceptional athlete, and we know that he does have phenomenal parents, but he's also surrounded by a village of people that aren't going to let him, you know, step to the left or the right either way.
And that's so important, and that's one of the things that's been really great as we do more and more youth mini grants, and as we get out in the community more as an agency at BCAP, is we're getting to know the kids. I've been doing some stuff this summer at Olivet's on Clinton Street, and I was by there the other day, and we were actually at an event on Saturday over in Bear Park, and everybody's coming going, Miss Jodi, Miss Jodi, Miss Jodi, and it's so neat. It's so great to me that the kids recognize me and recognize me in a positive way. But I know from having so many great adults in my life growing up, how important that is, that there's another adult that's going to say, wow, you know, you look great today, or you did really good, or, you know, how's that spelling test, or, you know, those reinforcements that it really takes a village for the whole kid. And it's great that we've got programs like this, and we've got reinforcement for the parents, because I do not have kids myself, so I don't try to teach anybody parenting. And some of the stuff I see, it would scare me to death to have a teenager today. Mm-hmm. So knowing that there's extra help out there and things like that. So,
you know, Ms. Jodi, and touching on that, you know, we have discussed with several community leaders from the Olivets, the YMCA, the Reading Rec. We have talked about, you know, the basketball program and the model, and how we have aligned basketball, assisted in aligning basketball in Reading. And, you know, we call it, it's our Red Knight 8-80. Anyone, and I encourage anyone who is willing and able to help, please feel free to reach out to us. And there's one simple requirement, is loyalty. You know, there can't be any agendas. It has to be the students first. Mm-hmm. And if you can put the students first, and all your efforts are genuinely geared towards that, then we're all in. You know, because there's never enough people. You know, and people may ask, "How can I help?" I got a laundry list, okay, of where we can use some support.
So you don't turn away any help for Kids the Ball or for the basketball program at the high school.
Well,
and how do people contact you then?
Well, they can reach out to me via email at coachprhs@gmail.com. They could speak to the Butlers. They could speak to Tremaine. They could speak to Dr. Goodhart. There's always, you know, they could speak to one of the players and make a connection.
Okay.
With us. But, you know, we need it. I'm a strong believer that the Geigel and our basketball team is the heartbeat of the city. And I say that with confidence, but it just brings people together. And that's very important, and I hope that people continue to be drawn, enjoy the games, but know that everyone has a hand in what's happening. This is community. It's not one person. It's not just Wesley bringing up the ball. You know, it's not just me coaching. It's not just Lonnie dunking. It's not, you know, it's everyone, and everyone's energy is important.
And that's great, and you are right. There's so much support. I had the opportunity to talk with some of the women from the Squires Club. Mm-hmm. And, you know, was not aware of everything that they do to support the basketball team. And some of this stuff gets slid by, you know, people don't know about it unless their kids are involved. Mm-hmm. And I've seen a lot of parents who, even after their kids graduate and move on to college and sometimes past college, are still involved with the high school athletics because it's become a labor of love and they enjoy so much the kids and helping them and helping shape the young men and young women that come through the program. So, wow. Okay. Wesley, what am I forgetting here? Tell me about, you know, how many times do you practice?
We practice 2 times a week.
Oh, that's not too bad.
But even that, we still have like high school basketball practice. We have shoot arounds. We get in the gym when we want to.
Okay. So are you going to be in the high school team then this fall?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Okay. So we'll be looking for you in the paper and on 69 News. And so do you have a position that you play?
Point guard.
Okay. So that's one that doesn't score as much? Or?
Well,
I don't know. I don't know basketball. I freely admitted that.
Score, pass. Really, you do everything no matter what position you're playing.
Okay.
You're doing everything.
Oh, all right. So we should be cheering for you then starting November, October? Yeah. When do the games start? Oh, wow. That's great. So you're starting up at the high school this year in 10th grade?
Yeah.
Okay. Are you excited?
Yeah, I'm really excited.
Oh, that's great. How long do you think it's going to take you to learn your way around the building?
it's not going to take a while because I've been there ever since.
Okay, you can fit about 20 of my high schools into Reading High School, so to me that building's very intimidating. Okay, Mason, we've ignored you. So, do you go to the games then at KTB?
I watch them.
You watch them, and do you like to play basketball? Not yet?
I can do T-ball.
You can do T-ball? Okay, so you're getting into athletics too. All right, and getting ready to go to school?
Like this HDA now. And then other schools.
Wow.
But then there's no other school and now we're staying home.
Okay. So you're starting first grade then? Okay, so you got a year or two before you're eligible for KTB. But you're learning pointers and learning stuff from the big kids?
Well, it's good because from HGA, for being good, I got a TV from them to my house.
Wow.
And in my room.
Okay, well then when you go home, we'll have to make sure you know when this is going to get replayed so you can watch it on the TV in your house.
Well, I think I don't have that.
No?
I just have like a Netflix or G-Core or...
Oh, okay. Well, we're on the internet too. If you go to the bctv.org website, you can pick up all the different programs too. So you'll have to tell everybody you were a TV star. All right. So we've got a banquet coming up, right? All right. So tell me about the banquet on August 11th. You're going to be at the brand new DoubleTree. Mm-hmm. Everything's at the DoubleTree this year. Mm-hmm. Got a lot of stuff coming up there on August 11th.
Yes.
Are tickets available?
Tickets are available, and you'd have to touch base with Mrs. Tanya Butler.
Okay.
Who is the brains of the operation. Yes, Mr. Butler and Tremaine, she is the brains of the operation. But, you know, it's a groundbreaking opportunity. I think that it really solidifies how strong the effort for KTB has been, and now we can really celebrate all of these student-athletes, you know, accomplishments. You know, bringing them all together. There will be a boatload of kids there, and it'll just be awesome. I think it'll put a stamp of prestige to what they're doing. And I can't wait to see all of them dressed up in their little suits and...
Oh, that's... Yeah. Because the pictures on the website, a lot of times we'll see you guys, you know, relaxing after the three or four games you played in one day. Mm-hmm. I don't know if I'd be sitting up anymore. But out to dinner, and so the whole... You know, the program actually goes with the whole individual that, you know, they focus on the athletics and the academics. But, you know, being out in the community, being a good representation of the city and things like that. So most of your kids come from Reading or all of the kids come from Reading? Do you have any suburban athletes on the team?
There are some suburban athletes you know, from other schools that are on the team. The majority maybe have a parent who played at Reading.
Okay,
and that's... you know, or are at in the Catholic program, right, you know, school right now or whatever it may be. But, you know, we keep those relationships, you know, with those student athletes and their families. So we got a lot of love to spread.
That's great. So now, in terms of Berks County, you guys have a traveling team. Which is it, AAU? Am I correct, or is that something totally different? Okay, so are there other traveling teams in Berks County that you guys compete against, or you actually have to go outside of the county then for your tournaments and compete?
Both.
Both? Okay. Yeah.
But mostly outside of the county, outside of the state, that's mostly, but there's a couple of tournaments we did where we're facing kids from our own county.
Okay, so there might be a team over in Wilson or yeah. Birdsboro, or, oh, okay, as I'm... Basketball's new to me. All right. So you get to meet other kids, and you yeah. said the tournaments are normally 3 to 4 days?
Yeah, most of the tournaments are 3 to 4 days.
Okay. So how, I'm sure this stuff costs. How do you guys raise the money to do this? Is there a lot, do the student athletes do a lot of that, or?
Yeah, we fundraise, but also we're a basketball family, so... We have so many people that donate in our city, and they help us a lot.
Oh,
besides
great.
The fundraising, so it all comes together and makes it even greater.
Oh, a lot of proud grandparents and aunts and uncles and extended aunts and uncles. So, what kind of fundraisers have you done?
We did a spaghetti dinner.
Okay.
And we sold pretzel sticks.
Okay, you've been doing that for a couple of years.
Yeah, we have.
Okay. Oh, so that's neat. So the parents are getting involved in that, and okay, spaghetti dinners are a lot of work. I've done them. But you need to let me know, because we like to come out and eat at BCAP. So right. please be sure you let us know, and BCTV always will post that kind of stuff up on their information page. So, wow. So KTB's got a whole lot going on. 3rd grade through 10th grade, and then once they leave 10th grade, the idea is they'll come onto the senior high team?
Yeah.
Okay, so how many of your players came through the KTB system then, most of them?
Well, right now, yes, the majority. What's happening now is we are now just beginning to see
okay.
the players coming from KTB. Wesley and our guys going into their junior year.
Okay.
They're the ones who pioneered the effort. So I tell them all the time, they should be very proud of what they started, you know, and have stuck with, because their loyalty means everything. That's the base to what we, to the success. I have yet to determine how many will be a part, you know,
mm-hmm.
but sooner or later, the numbers will continue to climb, because virtually every player who's coming through Reading is coming through the KTB program.
Wow.
So you know that it is awesome to watch. I'd also like to quickly mention, as you say, a lot is going on. KTB and the Squires Club have constantly worked to collaborated in many efforts. And one of the big efforts, it was a huge success this year, with KTB and the Squires Club, was able to provide a $500 scholarship to every senior that graduated from Reading High School. And that was going to college.
Wow.
It was 7 scholarships in total, and it was awesome. You know, and if anyone, there's another way to help. As it says, some people may like to cook spaghetti. Some may just want to help with rides. Some may want to donate. There's always a way to help. And once again, they can contact myself, Tremaine Jones, the Butlers, or, you know, Dr. Goodhart if interested. But we hope to continue that. And make it tradition that, you know, if you're a senior, you've come through the program and you're now going on to college, you know, we want to give you a little token of our appreciation.
That's fantastic. And one of the things that broke my heart when I heard it is that there's a couple kids that fell through the cracks and were unable to commit to their college education because they needed something little like a housing deposit, or, you know, and didn't understand that whole system. And I know how hard you're working, and the school district administration is working to make sure these kids that have an opportunity to go to college get there and don't miss out on it,
mm-hmm.
Because it's so important. It's such an opportunity. And we're very fortunate in this area to have so many great schools, too, that you can, you know, start or complete your education within just a few miles of home. So... Oh, that's great. And the Squires Club does great things. And it's nice that... So did you see most of your seniors then on the team this year go to college?
Yes. Yes, they all did. They all signed to go. 4 of them are going to play basketball. And the other 3 will be their own academics.
Wow.
Yeah. One being Wesley's brother.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, that's... Penn State.
That's fantastic. I had the opportunity this winter to have an intern from Albright who was is at Albright on a scholarship. He's a football player, and totally knocked aside all my misconceptions about football players. Great young man, very intelligent and very helpful, and much better on the computer than I am, thank goodness. He helped me with the taxes. But the student athletes, it's just an opportunity for the kids to come out, and we're glad that this program goes in and helps them with that. Wow. So we've been talking today with the Coach Perez and Ms. Young Wesley Butler from Kids at Ball and Mason, who's a great KTB fan and supporter, about the Reading Kids at Ball program. So you said the year is from September to February for KTB? And
for?
If somebody, and they're coming through the Reading Youth Athletic Program. So the tournaments are mostly in the summer, or are they?
They're spring and summer.
Okay.
KTB tournaments are typically begin in about April.
Okay.
And they run till, as Wesley just said, they just got back from Nationals.
Okay.
Yeah, that was our last tournament. So
do you get to relax now? Are you done with KTB? And you get a couple weeks before you got to start practicing for high school ball?
Yeah, about 2 days, but then we start up camps. And then we go back until our fall, and we start preparing for the season again.
And then once basketball season and the playoffs are over, you're just about ready to gear up for KTB again.
I don't remember my last break from basketball.
So you don't get any time to like veg out and just eat horrible food and not be in training?
No, we're always in the gym.
Oh, that stinks. Now my young man who's on the Albright football team, John, they were doing like 5 a.m. workouts. I said, oh, I'd still be snoring at that time. So it really is a commitment. It is a huge commitment to the team, to the program, to the academics. Wow. Are you looking to keep on playing through college then?
Yeah, I am looking forward to it.
Any ideas on where you want to go?
Ohio State. That's my favorite basketball team.
Okay. And it's far enough away that you can't come home every weekend? Oh, that's great. So this is a wonderful opportunity for youth in our community. And if they want to get involved with Reading Youth Athletics, do they post their signups on their Facebook page and things like that, or?
Yes, they can go to, it's Reading Youth Athletics. There's actually a website, Reading Youth Athletics.
Okay.
So they can get signed up. Football signups are right now. We look forward to an exciting football season.
All right. Well, I want to thank everybody that came today, Mason and Coach Perez and Wesley.
Thank you.
Talking about KTB. I told my boss I would show off our brand new BCAP windbreakers. So once the weather breaks, you'll be seeing all the BCAP staff around town in these. It'd kind of be hard to miss us. It's pretty bright blue. But we definitely are branding BCAP. I want to thank BCTV for hosting us today, everybody at home that watched, and for everyone at BCAP, where we believe a neighbor in need is a call to action. Thank you.